Michael Trackis, I live here in Astoria. For 10 years, North Coast has faced the possibility of LNG plants being constructed here. And this uncertainty persists. I'm not really sure where you stand on this, nor Senator Merkley, nor Representative Bonamici. None of you, to my knowledge, have taken a very strong stand about this. Can you do so?
Well, let me tell you how I see it, and you can make up your own mind about my stand. That's what is good about meetings. You can get a sense of where people are going with things, and I'll just give you my opinion as bluntly as I can. There are two projects on the coast. One of them, of course, is in Warrington, and the other is in Jordan Cove. And I feel differently about Jordan Cove than I do about Warrington. And in fact, during the consideration of Jordan Cove project, I was actually chairman of the Energy and Natural Resources Committee, which essentially has jurisdiction over these projects. I was not chairman, in effect, at the time of all the decisions with respect to Warrington. I'll give you my judgment. The ports in and of themselves are a little bit different, not completely, but Port of Coos Bay has tended to be more of an industrial point port. The port here has been more of a fishing and tourism and related kind of considerations. And as the chairman of the Energy and Natural Resources Committee, I listened to the people of Coos Bay. It seemed to be quite divided about whether they were for it or against it. But I made the judgment that I wanted to make sure that with Jordan Cove, the citizens had the opportunity to go the distance with the process, that both sides would have a chance to make their case. Obviously, there are going to be major environmental issues and right-of-way issues and earthquake issues and tsunami issues and the like. But every time we had witnesses from the Department of Energy and the like, when Jordan Cove was being considered, I said, I want to make sure that at Jordan Cove, people have a chance to take this through the process. And a judgment that I made there is a little different than what I felt with respect to the situation in Warrington. My sense has been that the company up here really has not been interested in public opinion. And at one point, they basically said, you know, well, we're not that interested in decisions that are being made by local bodies. And I think the public has had more questions, you know, here. And I want to make sure that there is full consideration given to local officials and small businesses and everybody else whose livelihood could be affected by this decision. But I am considerably more skeptical about what's being done here. And when I saw that the CEO basically said that he wasn't interested in public opinion, I said, that's not the Oregon way. That's not the way we do things. We do things by bringing people together and listening to them, trying to see if we can find common ground rather than dismissing public opinion. So I've been very much following what local officials have had to say about this and their concern. They aren't being listened to. So I feel differently about the two projects.